Jessie, one of the eeriest things is that tomorrow is 16 years to the day since Hurricane Katrina hit New Orleans. So many terrible memories from that storm. And I think a lot of people are quite scared down there tonight.
Yeah, a lot of people are drawing comparisons between Ida and Katrina, and rightfully so. The intensity is close to the same. The track is awfully similar. The date is exactly the same.
So strange.
Kind of a strange situation. But I do want to talk about that storm surge that you just learned about and compare Ida and Katrina. As you might remember, Katrina, the storm surge, was one of the most devastating things. I mean, people in New Orleans lost their lives, their homes, because of the storm surge of Katrina. So the first thing we're going to do is compare the two tracks. So you learned there that the track is just part of the equation. Intricate little tiny shifts and details make a difference, and I'll explain here. This is the track of Ida, the expectation of Ida. We're pretty narrowed in here that it's going to be a Category 4 making landfall just south of New Orleans Sunday afternoon. Now, here's the track of Hurricane Katrina, this yellow line. Very similar, especially toward landfall. We're going to zoom in here. So here's where we expect Ida to travel. You see this northwesterly component. Keep that in mind. That's key. And then here's Katrina. It almost went due north as it was approaching the Louisiana coast. That made landfall as a Category 3 with winds of 125 miles an hour. We're expecting Ida to make landfall as a 4 of 130. Very, very close to the same intensity, but the direction, that actually makes a huge difference. And that's why at this time, and it's something we'll keep an eye on, there's still dangerous storm surge expected in the New Orleans area. But with that northerly track, that allowed the winds from Katrina to funnel in a little bit better here into Lake Pontchartrain, and that's where they saw 10 to 15 plus feet of storm surge in the New Orleans area. So that path allowed for that to happen as it moved over Lake Bourne and Pontchartrain. Those winds kind of funneled in here and brought in that very heavy storm surge. Again, that was Katrina. The tracks are going to be so similar with Ida, but this again is why we saw that 15 plus feet of storm surge. Now with Ida, we're expecting 10 to 15 feet, but a little bit farther south because of that northwesterly entrance of the hurricane. Notice though, New Orleans, still 7 to 11 feet. The track is so similar. If it starts to take a little bit of a more northerly or northeasterly jog, we may have to add that 15 feet into the Pontchartrain area. So right now it's 7 to 11 because of the track. It's such a very delicate thing to forecast, because of how sensitive just the smallest little direction changes, momentum changes, speed of the storm, wind speed at landfall makes a huge difference. A quick look here. If you remember last year, 2020, there were 4 landfalls in Louisiana. This is the last thing they need. Laura, which was the strongest hurricane that ever made landfall in Louisiana. Delta, Cristobal, which was a tropical storm, and Zeta, which was a Category 3. So Ida, there are hurricane warnings in effect for a good chunk of southern Louisiana outside of that tropical storm warnings. There's Hurricane Ida becoming more organized this afternoon. The eye is becoming more well-defined. That will allow it to explode in intensity over the next 24 hours before actually making landfall. Still a Category 2. Our new update comes out in about 30 to 40 minutes. Look for that on WFAA.com and then also on our social media pages. So the track remains the same. No big changes here. Just a closer look to show you. Landfall tomorrow sometime in the afternoon is a Category 4 with winds of 130 miles an hour. So this will be very close to New Orleans. Then it'll kind of take a more northeasterly jog before weakening back into a tropical storm Monday afternoon. Flooding rain, we talked about the storm surge, winds 130 plus miles an hour along the Louisiana coast, 10 to 15 inches of rain. The wind speeds, the rainfall, very similar to Katrina. Really, really similar numbers here. 5 to 10 inches for Mississippi and parts of Alabama. Again, up to 15 inches in Louisiana. So the high